Previously on The Bill.
I've just got your first job as family liaison officer.
Really?
What is it?
They found Karen's handbag in the undergrowth near the bus stop.
Sam, you cannot abduct her, right? You can't just take her against her will.
Where is she?
They're gone.
He's still in custody. He's had too much to drink. They've all just been sleeping.
I need to see Jack Meadows.
Would you like to take a seat, please? It's not here, sir, I'm afraid. It's not due until 8 o'clock.
One of your officers has abducted my girlfriend. So get Jack Meadows on the phone now, OK?
Sam! Sam!
Shh!
Why the hell didn't you call me sooner?
Look, I didn't want to involve you in all of this.
Well, it's a bit late for that now. I went to Hughes, you weren't there.
Shh, please.
I've been up half the night worrying about you.
Well, don't. Okay, I'm fine. We're fine. Well, come in.
This is crazy. Baxter's flat. Why here of all places?
Because this is the last place Hugh Wallace is going to look.
You're thinking you can use this, aren't you? Being here to lean on her.
Baxter's innocent. He didn't kidnap her. He's banged up for something Hugh Wallace did. And Abby needs to face up to that.
So what, you're just going to shout and scream at her till she sees sense?
Yeah. If I have to. Hugh Wallace is sick in the head. He drugged her. Look at her, Phil.
Well, what if you're wrong? What if you're wrong about all of this? No one's infallible, Sam. You can't force her to tell the truth. You can't make her say what you want to hear.
She was taken, against her will, from my house.
You were there, were you?
No. No, but I have neighbours. And they described... They saw Sam taking her out of there.
And who's to say that Abby didn't agree to go with her?
She had to break the window to get access to the place. Would you have had to do that if Abby wanted to go with her?
Well, whatever. It's not a kidnapping, is it? It's a domestic. You know, Sam is not happy about you shacking up with her daughter.
She spread lies about me. She's accused me of kidnapping Abby, of threatening her life.
Yeah, all right.
If I hadn't helped her work out that Baxter was holding her in that shipping container, Abby would be dead by now.
I'll send it up to CID, see if they can find her.
No, no. You have officers out of control. I want the DCI in here now! Or would you rather that I went to Barton Street? Wash your dirty linen in public? The Sue would be delighted about that, wouldn't he?
Do you want a cup of tea?
No power.
Oh, great.
It's under the stairs. And I've tried it. Look, Hugh as good as admitted taking Abby, imprisoning her and putting her life in danger, and Baxter was set up, right? But poor old Sam, she's emotional, isn't she? She's obsessed, she's mad.
I never said that, or thought it.
But you're thinking it now, though.
No. Look, you want to get to the truth, right?
I know the truth. I just need the evidence. Phil, I need you on my side.
Let's call the DCI and tell them where we are. Right, just explain that you need a day's compassion to sort things out with your daughter.
And we'll have half of Sun Hill round here. And you know that. He'll have reported Abby missing, he'd have spun it, said I'm having a mental breakdown.
Then we need to let him know that she's safe.
Just 2 hours. Please. Hey. It's all right, darling.
Any news on that, Mr. Bear?
Karen Burnett, yeah. The results are back in the bag they found in Waverley Park. The blood stains on it match her blood type.
And the husband has been told, hasn't he?
Yeah, PC Harmon's the family liaison officer, Gov. We're just on the way now to have another word with him.
Good. You all right? Is Sam phoned in?
No, the mobile switched off and we can't get a trace on it. And I've put Hugh Wallace in your office.
Well, give me a minute then, will you? See if I can get some sense out of him.
Sam drugged Abby. It was the only way that she could get her out of the house.
And what is it?
It was in my living room on the floor. It's a sleeping tablet, antidepressant, I don't know, something to knock her out. And she's pregnant, for goodness sake.
So Sam carried her daughter through the house and put her in the car.
Or walked her out. The point is that D.S. Nixon broke into my house and took Abby against her will.
And where were you?
Sam had called me and asked me to meet her in a bar. When I arrived, she wasn't there. Phil Hunter was. He slashed my tyres to delay me, stop me getting back to Abby.
So now you're saying that Phil Hunter is in on it too?
Yes.
And why didn't you tell Inspector Gold about this?
Well, what would she have said if I had? Oh, it's just a domestic. This was bound to happen, Jack. As soon as Sam started making allegations against me, you should have taken her warrant card.
Thank you, but I don't need your advice.
Well, you need someone's. Who's supposed to be in charge here? You've got an officer running riot out there. No one seems to be prepared to do anything about it.
If you were that worried about it, Hugh, why didn't you report it last night?
Because I've been out all night looking for them.
Look, Jack, I'm really worried about Abby. And nobody else seems to be remotely interested.
You've made an allegation, Hugh, and we shall look into it.
Thank you.
Right, well, unless there's anything else you want to tell me, we've got all the information we need. I'll be in touch as soon as there's something to report. You show Dr. Wallace out.
Well, do you believe him?
He's reported a crime. We've got to investigate it. Keep trying a mobile and get someone to the house. It's a crime scene. Talk to the neighbours. If his story checks out, Sam is in big trouble.
He drugged you. You're pregnant.
No. No. They were just sleeping pills. After you left, I needed to rest.
No. Sit down.
Let me go.
Sam. It's not the way.
You don't like it, don't get involved. You do as you're told.
Excuse me?
This isn't simply a missing persons inquiry anymore, Mr. Burnett. Karen's bag was found in the park. So, the night that she went missing...
Got back here about 6:30. Karen normally gets in half an hour later. I made a call, and I started getting some food ready.
I mean, she didn't come back.
I tried a mobile. No reply, so I went looking for her. And then I called you.
Waverley Park, what do you think Karen was doing there?
She wouldn't walk home to the park, would she?
No, no, of course not. Not in the dark.
How's your marriage, Mr. Burnett? No falling out, no fighting?
We were happy. I wouldn't lay a finger on her. You know, I realise it's your job to do this, but... Karen's alive, OK, and... You need to concentrate on finding her and not questioning me.
Is there nowhere else she could have gone? Did she make an arrangement to go somewhere after work?
Well, no, only what I've said already. We were going for a drink with a friend and it was called off. I've told you that.
Do you mind me asking who this friend is?
Just a friend. We were going for a drink and he phoned to cancel. Hang on a sec.
You have 4 old messages. Message. Message. Message.
Hi, it's Greg. Look, I'm going to have to cancel tonight, mate. I've got a meeting. I don't know when I'll get away. I'll call you later.
Greg.
Campbell.
You got an address for him, have you?
Well, he'd be at work. He runs a delivery business, dispatch company, Oxford Lane.
He panicked yesterday, didn't he?
What are you talking about?
There was that moment when I gave you the present for the baby. And you smiled. Didn't you? You forgot yourself for a moment.
No.
Yeah. And he panicked. Because you're the only person in the whole world who has power over him. You're the one who knows what really happened. Why did he do it, Abby? Why did he make me think you were gonna die in that container?
You know why. He told you. He wanted you to know what it's like to love someone and then lose them.
You're saying I'm right? He abducted you. You're admitting it.
I'm not saying anything. Nothing. I'm not admitting anything.
You know, you can do whatever you want. You can walk away.
Why should I? Me and Hugh are equals. We respect each other.
Oh, right. Is that why he drugs you, to keep you in the house?
No.
Yes. Come on then, talk to me, Abby.
What, share a little mother-daughter moment? Oh, sure. You're trying to get me to grass on him. You're probably wearing a wire, Mum.
Oh, this isn't police business. I'm not interested in putting Hugh Wallace away. This is unofficial, all right? This is personal.
What? Not thinking about your job for once?
You don't get it, do you? I couldn't care less about my job. This is about you and me.
You were never a mother to me. And worse than that, you stopped me from seeing my father.
A child lost his life because of him. Put yourself in my shoes. What would you have done?
You still don't get it, do you? Whoever he is, whatever he's done, you stopped me from knowing him. I had a right to know him.
When you were abducted, I did contact him. He wasn't interested. Have you heard from him since? Maybe I should have told you who he was when you were younger. But I didn't, because I didn't want to see you hurt.
You won't want to hear this. I don't want to be strong and independent like you. I want someone to take care of me.
And you think Hugh is going to do that? You honestly think that when all this is over, he's going to be there for you?
Oh, you're praying he won't be, aren't you? So you can turn round and say that nutter ruined your life.
I wish that I was wrong about this. But I'm not. And you know it.
Morning, gentlemen. Greg Campbell.
Scott Burnett said we'd find you here, Mr. Campbell.
You had an arrangement to meet up with him and his wife 3 nights ago.
Yeah, I had to cancel. Why, what's happened?
Oh, she didn't get back home from work.
Right. Sheila, can you give us a minute, please? Thanks.
So when was the last time you saw her?
About a week ago.
Here?
Yeah, she came round to discuss going out. Look, is Scott okay? He must be tearing his hair out.
Can you think of anywhere she might have gone? Or any reason to take off like that?
No, she tells Scott she's going down the corner shop, you know, and he likes to know where she is.
Really?
You said you haven't seen her since last week, right?
Yeah.
So how come her name's in the visitor's book the night she went missing? She signed in at 7:30.
I don't know, I was at a meeting.
Did you return? Was she here waiting?
I didn't come back. Well, I did come back, but it was not till much later. I had to drop some stuff off. In fact, I did call in at theirs on the way home, just before 10.
Mr. and Mrs. Burnett?
Mm-hmm. For last orders, Scott wasn't up for it.
So you spoke to him? And he didn't mention Karen?
No.
He didn't seem anxious or...?
No, he was fine, normal. Look, I don't understand.
Honey, it's Terry. Can you check something out for me?
Okay, I'll call you straight back. Karen was at your friend's workplace the night she went missing.
Well, Greg saw her.
He said he wasn't there. Did he call around here later, just before 10?
Well, no. I mean, I was out looking for Karen.
So you didn't see him?
No, no way. What the hell's going on?
Hello. Cheers. I think we need to carry on with this discussion down at the station.
Phil, my office now. Hugh Wallace's car. Did you slash the tyres?
What? Of course not. He told you I did that, did he?
Look, I know you're loyal to Sam, but don't flannel me. I need to know where they are. Yeah.
You wanted to see me, Gov?
Have you been to Hugh Wallace's?
Yeah, I spoke to that neighbour.
And? Well, go on.
Well, she said that she saw D.S. Nixon holding Abby up as they were coming out of there. At first she thought Sam was breaking in until she flashed a warrant card, so when she saw her and Abby coming out of there, she just presumed that she was being arrested.
Anything else?
Well, yeah, she said it looked like Abby was drunk.
Drugged. Sam drugged her.
Who told you that?
Hugh Wallace.
Also, there was a window smashed. There was some damage inside. It did look like there'd been a struggle.
Oh, come on, Gav, you can't believe all this.
Thanks, Gary. Well, why shouldn't I? You're going to tell me something else? I mean, is there something I'm missing?
Okay, look, I didn't want to get dragged into this. Right, but Sam, she called me yesterday, asked me to waylay Hugh so she could talk to Abby alone.
And that's what you did?
Well, yeah. It was a personal matter, nothing to do with business. Anyway, then I call her, and the next thing that I know is she's saying she's found Abby in Hugh's, drugged up to her eyeballs. She's got to get her out of there.
Well, that's not the way Hugh Wallace sees it.
Yeah, well, he's spinning a yarn.
Go on.
Well, to panic everyone. To make you believe that Abby's in danger so that you pull out all the stops to find them.
Yeah, well, whatever. An allegation's been made. You know what the rules are? I want this put into bed. Now, you've spoken to her. Where are they?
I wish I could help you, Gav. They were driving. She called me from the car. They could be anywhere now. Is that what you need me for, Gav?
For the minute.
I went to their house the other night, like I said, and I saw Scott.
And he didn't mention Karen.
Well, either he's lying or you are.
I'm telling you what happened, okay? They've been having problems with money, right? Karen's run up debts on her card, so, well, she asked me to bail her out, lend her a couple of grand.
Did she?
Yeah. But Scott doesn't know about it. She doesn't want him finding out. He worries. I mean, he's a great guy, but he's not the best at it.
What?
Well, he wouldn't be too pleased, would he? Would you?
Is that what she came to see you about? Money?
I don't know. I didn't speak to her. I wasn't there, was I?
Oh, no, that's right. You weren't there, were you? But someone must have let her in. Karen signed herself in at 7:30, but she didn't sign herself out again, so we've got no idea what time she left the building.
But luckily, you have security cameras, and we've checked the tapes.
The tapes are wiped every day?
No, the tapes are rewound and recorded over on a weekly basis, so the events of the other night are still there. That's Karen, right? Going into the building. Bang on time, coming up to 7:30.
Okay, look. She doesn't always tell Scott she's coming to see me. He can be difficult. Sometimes it's best to...
What? Sneak around behind his back?
You said you weren't there, right? So?
Okay, look, I can explain. I should have told you earlier. We've been seeing each other. She wanted to finish it, and, Scott had been asking questions. She was frightened of him finding out. I haven't hurt her, if that's what you're thinking.
You put amateurs on the streets, give them a uniform. It's a disaster waiting to happen. Instead of doing what we ought to be doing, we're running around babysitting some middle-aged woman and a bloke who reckons he's Dirty Harry.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Right, what's going on?
She's been carrying on, breaking glass, bottles. Colin had a word with her and she started up screaming and shouting.
Oh, right.
Get away from me! Get away from me!
I'll stop. I can handle it.
Get away from me!
Come on, before you do yourself an injury.
Get away from me! Get away from me! Get away from me! Get away! Get away from me!
Hey, so come on, come on.
It's all right. It's all right. No one's going to hurt you, I promise. Come with me. All right, love.
Yeah, what I tell you, we can handle it.
Oh, yeah. You're very lucky, mate. The current's strong here. Another step, you could have been retrieving her body. I'll rest my case.
I've seen you before.
Me? Long time ago. But I've seen you.
People like her are unpredictable, so you have to show a bit of restraint.
Right.
And listen the next time someone tells you to back off. Now, you're doing all right, but a bit more of this and a bit less of that, and you'll be fine, all right? Laura, come on.
She didn't even tell me her name.
Her name's Mary Ellis, and she's a regular here. And she's an head case, and I mean that in the nicest possible way. We're going.
Is that it?
Yeah, that's it.
But she was beginning to talk to me to open up.
And that's exactly what she wants, is a chat. She wants a hot meal and a bed for the night. That isn't us. That is social services. Let them deal with it. We're going.
Do you know whose flat this is? Peter Baxter's. The poor guy has served his sentence, he's getting his life back together when, bang, he's back inside.
Baxter's a pervert.
He was set up by Hugh.
Baxter is a rapist, he deserves to be in prison.
Not for something he didn't do. That's wrong. And you know that. Hugh used him. Like he used you. Can you live with that? Can you have a child with that man? Do you still believe that he's decent and honourable and motivated by love?
Well, I understand how you feel. You want to give Sam and Abby some time.
What are you getting at, Hugh? You got something to say, then say it, all right? No games.
Okay. Tell me where they are and call it quits. You carry this on, it's going to damage your career. I'll take it to the highest level. We're talking about intimidation, abduction.
You'd know all about that, wouldn't you?
Oh, according to Sam. But you believe her, wouldn't you?
Well, either she's a nutter or you are. I know I like to put my money on. See, the more I think about it, the more it makes sense. Like Sam didn't drug Abby, you did.
Where are they, Phil?
What else you lied about?
Where are they?
The trouble is, Abby's a bit of a loose cannon, isn't she? She's young, she's naive, she's impressionable. You know what I think? See, I think you're in deep. You give Sam another hour, she'll get Abby to talk.
She's right, isn't she? 100%!
The game's up, mate.
I said I want to see someone now!
Please, just calm down, sir. Inspector Gold is on the way.
Hugh, I'm very sorry, but we've got no news at the moment, but I promise you that as...
I have just been assaulted by one of your officers.
Okay, if you'd like to come in here.
I don't think you understand the position you're in, Mr. Campbell. Karen is missing, you were the last person to see her, and the video shows you being aggressive.
Look, she was going to leave, Scott, okay? That was the arrangement, and then she told me it was off.
Then what? You wouldn't accept that?
Oh, because it's not what she wanted. Not really. She was just frightened of Scott.
Why, did he threaten her? Was he violent towards her?
No, it's just a big step, isn't it? She, well, it would break his heart. She was upset, and she wasn't thinking clearly.
And what did Karen do when she left the building?
She ran across the car park. I went after her. I offered to take her home, and she said she wanted to walk and think.
And you let her go?
Of course I let her go.
And you called in at Scott and Karen's house later. Why?
I thought maybe I'd see her on her own. Maybe I could persuade her to change her mind and make her come with me.
There's something you need to know. Karen's shoulder bag was found dumped in Waverley Park. We're going to need some DNA. We need to organise a search of his workplace and the surrounding area. Have you contacted the FMA?
Yeah, he's in there, though.
Just to let you know that Hugh Wallace has made a formal complaint.
Against?
Phil Hunter, for assault and harassment.
Hugh crushes you, doesn't he? Emotionally, takes you to pieces, and then when he's got you as low as he can possibly get you, he lifts you up, tells you how wonderful and precious you are. Is that it? Is that how it works? Well, he's making sure that you need him. He's keeping control over you. It's all a game.
I'm not going to tell anyone else about Hugh abducting me. Not officially. There's no way I'm going to inform on him.
Well, I told you. It's not why I'm here. I just want you to know that you can come and be with me and you can be safe. Okay?
We searched S. Nixon's house, D.S. Hunter's flat, but there's no sign of him, Gov.
I want this sorting, Gary. Where would you take her?
Hotel, maybe. B&B. We're checking it as fast as we can, Gov.
Well, maybe somewhere to do with Abby's abduction. So if D.S. Nixon wanted to put pressure on her to talk, she'd take her somewhere. Somewhere with resonance.
Like?
The container park. Get it checked out.
And if D.S. Nixon's there, Gov?
Bring her in. Phil, my office.
Gov?
What are you playing at? Have you completely lost your marbles? Hugh Wallace has made a complaint. Harassment and assault at the Alcott Arms. And he's got witnesses. You've gone too far on this one. Go home. I don't want you anywhere near this case. You're off it.
Oh, but come on, Gov.
Enough!
What do you mean you're going to jack it in? You've only just started the job.
Well, yesterday I made an illegal search, right? So today I do it differently. Talking to the woman in hospital, thinking I can contribute something. That's wrong as well.
It's a social services case.
So what am I bringing to the job then? I mean, what's needed are street wardens, people like Colin. So why am I doing it?
Mom?
Don't you look at me. You're babysitting them.
Sarge, Mary Ellis, the vagrant.
Yeah, what about her?
She's kicked off again, in hospital, shouting for Laura. Wants to talk to her, apparently. Just thought I'd pass it on.
Do you want me to go and sit with her, keep her quiet till something else turns up? Not doing much else here, am I? Well, I can gab. I am good at that.
Yeah.
All right. Why don't you?
Let's do secret weapon. The WI.
Always liked a man in uniform. Well, you wouldn't like him very much.
Yeah, all right, Gabriel, just a sec. Mary, do you remember where you were from before you were living like this? Don't you know? You said you remembered me from somewhere. You said you'd seen me.
The Mayflower.
What, the social club?
You were working there.
Well, yes. Yeah, it was a while ago now. How did you know that?
Gave me money one night. Something to eat, too. And the next night.
I got a better memory than you, sweetheart. I remember your face by the river this morning.
The Mayflower. It was on Ellis Square, wasn't it? And that's your surname.
Good things I make sure I remember. She helps me.
Can I see?
My lady, Mary, she watches over me. awfully tired, love. Why don't you rest for a bit?
Come on. We've been here long enough.
Are you sure you're telling us everything?
Yes. I don't know anything else. If I did, do you think I'd be standing here like this?
No, I have to ask, Scott.
Yeah, but there's a tone in your voice. Like an accusation.
No! I'm trying to help.
They were having an affair, weren't they? Doesn't matter. I just want a home.
Jim, Terry. Okay, everyone, we've got something. Let's get this area sealed off and let's search the waste ground, yeah?
Yeah, this is DC Perkins. Put me through to DCI, please.
Over here. We found them. Just get over there.
Oh.
One of the PCs helped me look on Merlin. Mary Ellis, only real name Barbara Earle. Went missing from home, Lewisham.
Yeah, you're right. Contact's local. John Earle's the husband. We'll give him a call, eh? Well done.
How is it possible that somebody could just up and vanish like that? Like they never walked on the face of the earth. My wife. What's happening to her?
We don't know, Mr. Earle, not fully. She calls herself Mary Ellis.
That's not her name.
No. The doctors are unsure of how much she actually remembers about herself. Whether there was a trauma that may account for the memory loss or...
Well, whether it was a kind of choice. Maybe she just wanted to disappear, you know, be someone else. That is what happened, isn't it? She did just disappear.
Come home from work and she wasn't there.
Right. Well, there must have been a reason. People don't just walk out.
We had a son. He was 12 years old. He got killed. Car accident. Barbara was driving. People rallied round. I left work for a while to be with her. But she couldn't make peace with it. She couldn't bear to live within herself. It took her good sense away. How did you find her?
We talked. She remembered me. We met a little while ago.
I don't know what to say. Thank you. I thought I'd lost them both. Thank you.
Oh, no. No, I don't know why you're doing this job either. Because I can't for the life of me think what you bring to it.
Check the container site, there's no sign there. The security on there 24/7. Now they've seen nothing.
Right, Jack.
Can I speak to you, please?
Well, actually, I'm on a call. I'll see you when I get back. DC Best will fill you in.
Right, we're trawling hotels, B&B.
Oh, great. That's going to take forever. We need some focus on this.
Right, well, we've just checked that container site. The DCI thought maybe DS Nixon might have taken the daughter there.
Why?
Well, to get information. He thought maybe DS Nixon had taken her there to jog her memory, use the connection with Baxter to try and clarify things.
Baxter.
Right. Look, if we get any more information, I'll let you know.
Thank you.
It's a blow to the back of the head with a blunt weapon. Possibly the Wilburys.
Was the body moved?
Well, there is a trail of blood leading to it, so yeah, it was probably moved and dumped here.
So, the attack happened here, and the bag was placed in Waverley Park as a smokescreen, is that it?
If it was Campbell, you would have thought he would have dumped the body elsewhere. I mean, why drag it here next to the depot? It's only going to incriminate him.
Well, maybe that was the intention, to pick Campbell up with it.
You reckon we should talk to the husband again?
Yeah, absolutely. It's a murder investigation now, though. MIT are on the way over. They'll decide how to proceed.
They found a body.
Karen?
Yeah, it looks that way. But we can't be absolutely sure until we've got a proper identification. Scott, I'm going to have to ask you to identify the body.
Where is she?
Scott.
It's work. Depot. Is that where she is?
No, you listen to me. There's a forensic team down there collecting evidence right now. They're not going to let you anywhere near the site.
I should have known. Shouldn't I? I should have known.
Come on. It's not your fault.
This has got absolutely nothing to do with me.
The major investigation team will want to question you now.
Listen, mate. You have to talk to Scott. You have to ask him why Karen was so frightened of him.
Look, anything you've got to say, you say it to them.
Will he be able to stay here?
I don't know. It's been passed on to a specialist team, and they'll want to place their own officer here.
I want you here with me.
Well, I'll call in. Say I can't stay, then I will.
I'll make your mind up, Smithy. One minute you can't get out the door fast enough, the next you want a fast track.
Yeah, why not?
To what? PC?
Yeah. Look, I know I said the CSOs were a pain, but Laura's different. People like her, they talk to her. And that's what we want, isn't it?
Absolutely.
All right. Got that vagrant woman sorted then?
Yeah.
So when are we getting back out on the mean streets of Sun Hill?
You're wasting your time, mate. To get on this job, you need to be a menopausal battle axe.
Hey, the DCI's gunning for you. That Hugh Wallace has made a complaint.
Yeah, you're not kidding. It's old news, Gary. Already heard, mate.
I'm off home.
Well, I'd go out the back way if I was you. That Hugh's hanging about the front office wanting to know what was going on. I just spoke to him.
And?
Well, I'm what? I just told him that we're checking the hotels, the usual, and that Peter Baxter connection.
What Baxter connection?
Well, the DCI wanted me to check out any places that was associated with Peter Baxter.
What, you told Hugh Wallace that?
No one's saying you have to make a decision straight away about this, okay? Whether you stay with Hugh or not. I just wanted you to be able to listen to me. You know, maybe now you can take some time out and think about things properly. All right? Come on.
Herbs, let me in.
Your choice.
Abs, open the door.
I need to stay a while. I need to think.
Sam! Yeah, it's Dear Santa. I need to speak to the DCI right away. Sam!
Are you all right? Just get your breath. Surely now you can see what I was trying to say. Abby, did you see the look on his face?
You want me to get rid of the baby, don't you?
That's not for me to say.
But you said you wanted me rid of you. That's what you said.
No, listen.
You said you wanted that.
Listen. We'll take this one step at a time, all right? Hugh's got inside your head. He's telling you how to live your life. The last thing you need is for me to do the same.
I need you to help me.
Oh, darling. Of course I will. We'll find a space, all right? That's the best thing to do right now, and then you can get your head together. And you can decide what you want to do about Hugh and the baby.
And you'll help me.
Of course I will. I'm not going anywhere. I promise.
Abby? Abby!
Wait here.
It's at the railway arches at the back of Baxter's flat.
This isn't right, is it, Hugh? You're supposed to be in control, aren't you? Twisting the knife, making me suffer. Well, your time's up.
I'm not going to let you do this.
Do you remember when Abby was missing? And I asked you why? You remember? You said...
So you'd know what it was like to love someone and lose them. Yeah. I wanted to make you suffer, Sam. For what you did to your daughter.
Oh, right. You've twisted this whole thing right from the beginning. It's never been about Abby. It's about you and me.
No. No.
I never wanted you. I never needed you in my life. In my work, in my bed, and you couldn't stand that. Well, enough! You stay away from her!
Go!
This way.
Listen to her, Abby. She's doing it again. Turning it round so it's all about her.
Don't do this.
Listen to her. Do you see what's happening? She's trying to make it look like it's about me and her. But we know it's not. It's about me and you.
If you go now, you walk.
What's she been saying to you? That I'm violent, hurtful, abusive.
You can get away with this, Hugh. If you just go now, no charges and no further investigation. Just go.
We had to show her what she'd done to you, Abby. She had to know. I'm here for you now. We're so strong together. Come. Come on. We can talk about this.
You, please. Please.
Sam!
We're here!
All right, Hugh.
We're all right. We're okay.
Sam, come on over at the gate.
Come here. Remember what I said.
She's just trying to pin a crime on me. That's all this is to her. Another feather in her cap.
If you've got some information, we can help you. We can protect you.
Don't throw this away, Abby. What we've got is special, isn't it? We can make this right. For us. For our baby.
Oh.
We can do this together. Don't leave me now. Please. Come home.
Oh.
Good girl.
Sam, I have to tell you in.
You gotta know when you're beaten, Sam. You lost. Now just walk away and leave us alone.
Like I said, Abby, it's just a game to him. That's all it is, a game of power and revenge. I made a mistake.
Abby.
Peter Baxter's innocent. He had nothing to do with this. You kidnapped me. You threatened to kill me. And raped me.
Well, I'm arresting you for kidnapping. You don't have to say anything about Abby defense if you do not mention me.
Next time on The Bill.
Abby and I are in love with each other.
I wanted someone to love me. Don't let him get away with this.
I just want a home.
How could you get a bloke whose wife's just been murdered?
You don't want to put up with me like this.
That's what I'm here for.